Hey guys, today we will discuss about grids used in radiology. It is an important topic in radiology, so you should understand the concept behind using grids. First of all, why it is used and where it is used, and then the different types of grids and how they work. So let's start. Please don't forget to subscribe and press the bell icon to get the future notification. First question is why it is used. Grids are like a barrier. It is used to remove the scattered radiation, which eventually improves the image contrast. Now, what is scattered radiation? It is a type of radiation which has undergone a change in the direction during passage through a substance. For an example, let's take these two rays. Here you can see, after penetrating the target object, there is no change in the direction for the first ray. However, in case of second ray, the direction or path has changed. So, the radiation because of this second type of ray is called scattered radiation. This type of radiation is responsible for film fog. Now, let's see where it is placed. Here you can see, this is the source of radiation, this is the target object, and this is film. The grid is actually placed in between the target object and the film. The concept is very important, because lots of multiple choice questions are already made on this concept. Now let me ask you a question. What do you think? Does the grid reduce radiation exposure? As you already know that it acts like a barrier and removes scattered radiation. The answer is no, because it is placed just behind the target object. So the rays which are passing through the target object is unaltered. So grids do not reduce the radiation exposure. Let's see how it works. Grid is a sheet of radiolucent material in which lead strips are incorporated. Here, this is the radiolucent material and these are lead strips. They are parallelly placed with each other. Now, after penetrating the target object, primary beams pass through this small gap between the lead strips and fall on the radiographic film. However, the scattered photons move obliquely and strike the lead strips at an angle and get absorbed by them. That's how they remove the scattered radiation and prevent the film fogging. Here, I would like to mention that the grid is used in extraoral radiography. Now, let's discuss about the types. There are mainly two types of grids, stationary and movable grid or Potter-Buckey diaphragm. Stationary grids are of four types. Linear or parallel grid, focused grid, pseudo-focus grid, and cross grid. Let's discuss one by one. In linear or parallel grid, lead strips are placed parallel to each other. Now, if you see, the central rays of the beam is almost parallel, but the peripheral rays are divergent. So, at the periphery, the divergent primary photons get cut off or get absorbed. Therefore, the grid has to be modified. So, what they did? Nothing but focus the lead strips towards the X-ray source. Here comes the focused grid. Here you can see, even in the periphery, the lead strips are placed parallel to the divergent peripheral rays. Next type is pseudo-focused grid. In this type, there is progressive diminution in the height of lead strips from the center to the periphery. As the strips are shorter at the periphery, the primary photons are allowed to pass. Now the last type of stationary grid is crossed grid. In this type, two grids are placed at right angle to each other. This type of grid is used to eliminate the X-ray photons which are scattered in the plane of lead strips. Now, movable grid or Potter-Buckey diaphragm. If a stationary grid is used, the rays are absorbed by the lead strips and white lines appears on the film. This can be eliminated if the grid is moved at a regular speed during the exposure. Such movable grids are called Potter-Buckey diaphragm. So finally, let's sum up the advantages and disadvantages of grids. First, let's see the advantages. The presence of grid is usually able to remove as much as 80 to 90% of the scattered radiation. It helps to reduce the film fog and increase radiographic contrast. Some clinicians have found it useful to superimpose fine white grids when exposing radiographs because it helps in measurement of relative bone height. Now, some disadvantages. The exposure time has to be increased as the LED strip absorbs the X-ray photons and reduces the number of incident photons. So, grid should be used only when improved image quality and high contrast is necessary. That's all, guys. If you have enjoyed this video, please like, comment, and share, and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.